Welcome back into the Proactive Investors New York studio. I'm Christine Corrado. Joining me in the studio today is Gavin Lockyer from Arafura Resources. Gavin, great to see you again.
Good to see you too. Thanks for having us.
It's been a few months since you've been in New York, but your last chat actually with Proactive was with Danielle in Sydney, where you updated her on the company's DFS study. Just give us the highlights really briefly.
The study highlighted the fact that the project is technically and economically viable. So it's a big milestone for the company. Three key takeaways from that is that it's a long life mine, it's a low cost operator, and it's solely in Australia, which is, you know, 100% from mining to end processing, all done in the one spot.
With Danielle, you had mentioned that you were having discussions with banks in Sydney on the project. How are things with that going?
Yeah, look, things are progressing. I also said to Danielle that my team is sort of spreading across the globe,
right,
looking for customers for potential offtake, but also speaking to financiers, and that's one of the reasons I'm obviously here in New York.
Any update on offtake discussions you can tell me here today?
Sure. Look, at the moment we've got a non-binding offtake with one rare earth company in China, but we've also got two non-binding offtakes for our phosphate product, which is going into the Indian fertilizer market. So things are progressing.
Very exciting to hear.
Yeah, absolutely.
You mentioned you're here in New York meeting with other potential investors.
Yes.
I understand you're going to be at the Union League Club meeting with those investors. Can you give me the kind of the breakdown of that?
Yep. The Australian government's been working with the US government on critical mineral supply. Australia obviously is a miner of many critical materials, and the US is a big consumer. So the Australian government has it's brought a delegation of us over here to meet with potential financiers, but also some policymakers.
So the first meeting will be here in New York, and then that second meeting that you alluded to will also be in DC.
Correct.
Meeting with those policymakers. Who else will be in attendance at that meeting?
So there's a couple of other Australian rare earth projects. This is purely rare earths, this delegation. Some of them produce other types of rare earth materials, but we're the predominant NdPr supplier.
So the US, where do they currently receive their NdPr supply from?
Most of it comes from China. China supplies 80% of world supply. The rest comes from a company, Linus Corporation, out of Australia, but they do their processing in Malaysia, and predominantly that product goes into Japan and their magnet market.
So what has to kind of be set in motion for the US to actually form these partnerships with mining companies in Australia?
Well, part of the delegation, or the purpose of this delegation, is to put manufacturers from the US and financiers in the same room as the miners. We need offtake from those customers, and we also need project finance. So the offtake will help generate project finance, and obviously, because it's a non-traded commodity, not like a gold or a copper, the offtake is critical to underpinning finance.
So what is the level of financing that you'll need right now?
Look, our feasibility study showed that we needed about $1 billion Australian dollars,
okay,
to build, which is, you know, a significant number. Even if you convert it to US, it's still a big number. And we're a small market cap company. You know, the financing, we'd expect it to be roughly 60% debt and maybe 40% equity on a good day, but maybe 50-50 would be where it probably ends up. So with $1 billion, we still need a lot of debt and a lot of equity. And obviously the US is a key market for us.
And who would some of those manufacturers be that you would be forming those partnerships with?
Yeah, well, most of the big end users are in the automobile industry. So in Europe, obviously, you've got Volkswagen that's got some extremely ambitious targets for electrification of their motor vehicle fleets. But there's others in the clean energy sector, such as Siemens, General Electric, all use rare earth magnets in many of their products.
Just going back to the project itself, when can we see construction beginning?
If in an ideal world, if we get financing tomorrow, we've got about a 30-month lead time to finish off detailed engineering and design, and then we've got about a three-year ramp-up on top of that. So in an ideal world, 2022 would be first production.
So hopefully we can check in with you after that meeting and see how talks have gone so far.
Absolutely, that would be fine. And hopefully we get some good news on offtake as well over the coming weeks.
Great to have you here. Thanks so much for being with me here in New York.
Not a problem. Thank you for having me.